welcome to my channel. My name is Wolo. I love to share information. So I want to say thank you to everyone who have subscribed to my channel and have seen my videos. I really appreciate your subscription. And I also want to quickly apologize to people. I have not responded to their emails. I have been very busy this week and I hope to respond to all the emails that are still pending before this week runs out. And I hope you understand and crave your indulgence. Today, I'll be talking about the tech industry in Canada because it is the fastest growing economic sector in Canada. A lot of employers are looking for people who have IT skills or who have experience in the tech industry. And that's why it's the fastest growing economic sector that employs people. Based on that, Ontario and British Columbia, especially Toronto and Vancouver, are the leading cities that employ people who have work experiences in the IT industry or in the tech industry. So for any new immigrant who is a tech person, if you know you're an IT person and you're planning to come to Canada, I suggest that you target Ontario and British Columbia so that you can easily get jobs, because these are the places where you can get jobs as an IT person. There is a forecast that the IT industry will be competing highly with the US IT industry very soon. And that's because many IT people or tech people are, you know, kind of leaving the US and coming to Canada. So we have this talent coming to Canada. There's so much demand for persons with IT skills or persons who have experiences or who have built their careers in the tech industry. So based on that, I will be discussing the human capital pathway or the Ontario immigration nomination pathway that is targeted to select tech people. If your occupation is in the IT industry, if you're a software developer, if you're a computer programmer, if you're a computer engineer, if you're a web designer, if you're a data analyst, if you are a computer and information systems person, then I suggest you target Ontario for a provincial nomination. So if you are interested in coming to Canada and you fall into any of this group of professions, and you have created your express entry profile and your score is not that high, let's say your score is about 435 and above, I suggest that you indicate Ontario as a choice of province so that you can be picked by the Ontario province for a provincial nomination. The recent trend is that the express entry draw scores has been high. It has been as high as 459 and above. So it's been difficult for people to, you know, get that high score to get an invitation to apply from the IRCC. And then Ontario now introduced the tech draws to target people whose occupations are in demand in this sector to give them provincial nomination that will boost their scores for an invitation to apply and then come to Canada and start working in Ontario. So this is how it works. The Ontario Immigrant Nominee Program started 2 months ago in searching the express entry pool for tech talents, and they started with a score of 440. That was in June, and then they gave those people provincial nominations. Now, yesterday, August 1st, they also searched the express entry pool for tech talent and gave provincial nomination to people who had a comprehensive ranking score of 435. And if your score is within the targeted score, they send a notification of interest to your express entry profile account, and then you have 45 days to respond to that notification of interest. And if you submit your application within 45 days, you are giving a nomination that will boost your score in the express entry profile, and then you get an invitation to apply to come to Canada. This information is for persons whose occupations fall in the information technology industry. If you know anyone who is an IT person and whose occupation is currently in demand in Ontario, please tell the person to choose Ontario as a province and just keep your fingers crossed. you might get a nomination from Ontario. In addition to that, I'll be talking about the salaries for the occupations that are currently in demand in the tech sector. So if you eventually get a nomination and you are coming to Ontario, this is what you should expect as salary when you finally arrive in Ontario and get a job. For a software developer, the average salary is $68,000 per annum and could grow as high as $100,000 and above. And then for a computer programmer, the average salary is $54,000 per annum and could grow as $80,000 to $100,000 and above, depends on your experience and qualifications. For a computer engineer, the average salary is $76,000 per annum. For a web designer, the average salary is $50,000 per annum. And then for a database analyst, the average salary is $62,000 and above. For a computer and information systems engineer, the average salary is $88,000 and above. So these dollars I'm talking about is Canadian dollars, not US dollars, so you don't get confused. And subsequently, I will be doing an analysis of what your disposable income is if you're earning any of this amount and you are living in Ontario. I will also be talking about targeted provincial nominations in Alberta and New Brunswick, and that will be in other videos. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day. Bye-bye.